On behalf of the Ateneo School of Government and Konrad Adenauer Stiftung, we would like to thank everyone for joining today's discussion. Maraming salamat rin po sa mga tumulong sa amin from the St. Louis University, especially our student volunteers from the School of Law.
What is coming? Change. And many would agree that a lot of change has happened in our country. Some would say for the bad, some would say for the good. No? Federalism po kasi is a re-engineering of the government bureaucracy. Way back in 1982, during the dark days of martial law, Nenny Pimentel and the founding fathers of PDP Laban already proposed a federal system for our country. Why are we pushing for federalism? We want to accelerate the economic development of the regions. If you look at Australia, for example, the centers of growth are in each of the states. Development is spread out. In our country, development is primarily focused on Imperial Manila. Federalism should improve the delivery of public service. Kailangan po maramdaman ng taong bayan ang gobyerno.
Federalism, one of the advantages is it will account for diversity, it will account for regional preferences.
Federalism offers a very good package. But the question is, do we really need it right now? Or are we just getting something na, kumbaga, bato na ipupukpok natin uli sa ulo natin?
Is really federalism the answer to the problems that were mentioned earlier? Problem of poverty, inequality, instability of our country.
The various local governments, the province, the cities, municipalities, and even in the barangays more so, we have this concept of mandate without funding. Bakit yung mandate nasa local government unit, bakit yung budget na iwan sa department?
Let's try first to make the current system work utilizing all laws that we have.
Once we decentralize authority and power to the different regions, we might lose that national identity that is needed.
Federalism is very costly because it will entail overhauling the constitution itself.
Yung golden rule, now we go back to that. He who has the gold rules. So, Manila do not want to part with the resources because that's the political economy for country. This allocation on land area, population, and the equal distribution is really not fair.
Yung billions na spend natin sa federalism, why don't we allocate it first in the industrialization of the poor areas of our country, in education?
There's this growing unrest in a federal system that can address regional preferences, regional aspirations, will prevent unrest.
We already have so many existing laws. And our only problem is, people would always say, it doesn't work. But the real question is, did we ever try to make it work?
I believe that all of us should really participate in this discussion so that we can bring out the best in each and every one of us in defining really what we want for our country. It has been long years and still the same issues are cropping up. And I hope and pray that we'll come out with the right system of government that will really address these problems.